Hello everyone, it's Gladius. Today we're going over the low effort, easiest things you can get for pre-BIS because nothing tastes sweeter than low-hanging fruit. Let's get right into it. So rules for this are going to be things that you can solo, things you can get by yourself. You don't need a group for this. You don't need a farm rep for this. You just go out and get the thing. So first of all, let's start with rings. If you didn't spam the living daylights out of graveyard in Scarlet Monastery, then you can go up there and get Ironspine's Eye. Ironspine's Eye is pretty easy to get alone. As a level 40, you can walk past most mobs. You're going to have to fight the interrogator in the first room. So the first boss you run into, you will have to fight him because he has an extended aggro radius. But beyond that, you don't really have to fight anybody else if you navigate around the enemies. Walk your way up to the actual graveyard portion and spam the macro. I'm going to link in the description. You should be able to find Ironspine. Next, the Ring of the Underwood should be not too expensive on the auction house. Just go ahead and check it for you to see if it's expensive on your server. This is a pretty common BOE that's been farmable for a while. So take a look, see if you can get it. Really easy low-hanging fruit is your boots. Excelsior's boots is going to be a great one to get for Horde players. It's available to all factions, but Alliance, we have a better one. I'll get into it in just a second. But you can get this quest from Drizzlik in Booty Bay. You're going to start with a quest called Supply and Demand. Go ahead and complete this quest, and then you're going to get some assembly required. And all these quests come from Drizzlik, where you're going to do first some assembly required, and then you're going to do Excelsior. And at the end of that quest chain with Excelsior, you're going to get your boots. Very solid boots to take into Nurmagon. But Alliance players, we want to get Wanderlust boots instead. These are going to have a little bit better stats for us. We can get this by going into, we're going to do a quest called Mazen's Behest. This is going to be available to us in Stormwind, where we can go to the library and accept a quest that's then going to send us to a quest giver that's actually in the same building, where then upon accepting the second quest, we're going to go over to Swamp of Sorrows, and we're trying to get a quest item called Khadgar's Dimensional Rift Notes or something like that. And we're going to have to go all around Swamp of Sorrows fighting elementals. The drop rate on this is abysmal. It probably took me like 15 kills or more, but you only need one of them. You only need one of them. So it has the potential of going fast or taking a little while, but as a level 40 character, you can go through this pretty quick. Either Sniper Rifle of Agility or the Mithril Heavy Bore Rifle. These are two options for you. First of all, the Sniper Rifle of Agility is a pretty common drop for, it's a world drop. So a lot of those are going to be on the auction house. If the price is really expensive right now, as time goes on and more of these are farmed out, it should drop in price. We'll see. But the Mithril Heavy Bore Rifle can be made by engineer. So if you are an engineer, these also should be available on the auction house if you wanted to check there as well. Dusky Bracers, you can get 8 additional agility on your bracers just by making these as a leather worker. A lot of us are leather workers, so we can make the current epic crafted gear. So you can just make these for yourself. If you're not a leather worker, well, you can just buy one of these off the auction house or have a leather worker make it for you. The reagents on this, the ingredients are not that expensive. So you can go ahead and buy those off the auction house and just have it made. It'll probably save you a little bit of cash from buying it on the auction house. There are more decently easy options for you to get for your pre-BIS to fill out the other slots. I have a guide in the description that goes over how you can get your best in slot chest. A couple other slots can be filled with items that you probably want to take a group to go get. They're not necessarily difficult, but you do have to group up for it. I wanted to focus just on the low-hanging fruit in this video for today. Also, I got a melee hunter guide coming out very soon if you want to stay tuned for that as well. All right, everyone, the video did help you out today. Please heroic strike the like button. If you want to stay tuned for more WoW content in the future, please bash the subscribe. I appreciate your time. I'll see you in the next one. Bye, everyone.